We don't know if they share our beliefs, share our religion. We don't know where it is. Actually, no one on board this ship knows where it is. I don't know, you don't know, our captain, their captain, or even their captain. And let's look around, like there's thousands of people here. And it's 1788, and the conditions are horrific. Of course they are, right? We have no access to resources, no access to sanitation. Forget about nutrition, we barely have enough water, and the food is rotten. Sickness is rife through the caverns. And the only thing that will get us through our 6,000-hour journey to the other side of the world will be our mental and emotional fitness. We have no access to resources. We actually have nothing. We have no target. We only have a destination. And so how are our chances of success look right about now? Well, they look pretty horrific, right? We have nothing. We have nothing. We have no access to resources. Our leaders don't know where we're going. We're being led by a bunch of idiots. So why don't we just keep on going? And how about chances of success look right about now? Well, they look pretty horrific, right? Who's glad that they came with me? What happens if I told you that this story was a success? What happens if I told you that as a proud Australian, what happens if I told you as a proud Australian that this story is a success story? What happens if I told you that as a proud Australian that this really worked, this really happened, we were really successful? How would your belief structures change then? So what we need to think about now is that it's never, and so the Australian story teaches us two things. The first thing is that sometimes your mistakes are your ticket to paradise. And the second thing that it teaches us is that it is never, ever, ever your access to resources that is the defining factor of your story. The answer is in your resourcefulness. Opportunities require clear targets and then in a belief it's possible. So then if we fast forward 200 plus years, now, and so if we fast forward 200 plus years now, and now we're bound for a new world, a world none of us know what it looks like. And if we think that if we keep going 200 plus years now and we think about that this is a world that we don't know what it looks like, now it's not 1788 anymore. We do have the resources. However, we are the success stories of our ancestors. We are the stories that have been of our ancestors that have been strong enough and fast enough and courageous enough to survive famines, to survive wars, to survive plagues. We are the most mobile, we are the most educated, we are the richest generation to have ever walked the planet. Yet with all of this, why do we still have the problems we have? Are we no better off than in 1788 on a boat with nothing? And if there's one thing that I can share in my life, is that I've had the pleasure of working with people from all over the planet, from all continents of the world. And there's one thing that these people tend to possess. And that thing is passion. There are those who just love what they do, and there are those who don't. There are those who go for everything that they have, with everything that they are, and those who don't. And what's the difference? And I really believe the answer is... Develop. How can we sign up for such a powerful life if we don't, if go there. You know, they just needed to get there. And the difference is, when you have the opportunity to think in terms of targets, your mindset changes because you move from someone that is thinking into the future and then you move to someone that is thinking in the now. And you completely commit yourself to every decision. Because the word decision means, the word decision means to cut into, right? So the word decision means to cut off from, to cut off from all other alternatives other than what you have decided. And that's the difference. Imagine if we approached our lives like that. If we approached our lives knowing that we would either die on the journey or arrive at the destination. You get very clear about your targets. And then you get very clear about your targets and then very serious about your actions. And so the second thing that we need to do after burning our boats, we need to give our quest meaning. We need to think in terms of what is it that I'm doing here? You are building a new world. Like the Australians, you're building a new world of opportunity. And it's through contribution and growth that we really find ourselves. We exist because of each other. We understand that we exist to serve. We exist to serve above self. And next one. However, so now that we've developed our targets, what's the danger in not having a target? And the danger is in no action. Not developing a target gives you an excuse to not be the person you're supposed to be. Not having a target gives you an excuse to not contributing your all in the world. The European cultures have been some of the most passionate dreamers of our times. This has been where our most deepest human contribution has blossomed. But today, we see a lot of our youth that are worried. You know, we're worried about having no jobs. We're worried about our future. What's going to happen next? However, so... we're worried, you know, what's going to happen. So when you think about it in terms of these highly human emotions, with no chance for contribution, brings conflict. That's when we start to get out of people that worry about their jobs and their futures. But when we do have a chance for contribution, when we do have highly fueled emotions mixed with a chance for contribution, such as in when we serve others, that calls for your best self. That calls for your better self. And while culture and tradition do play a tremendous role in our development, the real difference is, in these people of passion, is that they have two things available to them. They are motivated as well as being mobilized. They have a peaceful balance between their will and their way. And that motivation is that clear vision of the world as it could be. It's that vision of the world that is so compelling that it becomes not what you do, it becomes who you are. You move from someone who dances to a dancer, someone who paints to a painter. And then the next thing that you do is you take the next step into mobilizing yourself. Where you take your motivation and then you channel it into mobilizing yourself. And through this mobilization, you source the best resources. You source the best maps. You source the best strategies. You source the best mentors. And it's through these clues of the people of success around you that you can follow. And the wise follow these clues. And why, for example, do we know people who have every motivation to act, every tool to act, and choose not to, and it's their choice? Well, the answer is fear. But the question is it the fear of am I good enough, or is it the fear that perhaps I'm more powerful than I could ever possibly imagine? But then if we want better results, we need to ask better questions. And so maybe the question is, how can we cross this bridge of fear of the world as it is today to the world as it is tomorrow, the world as it could be? What does that look like? And the fear needs to be channeled into resourcefulness, that deep inner connection with your inner humanity, that resourcefulness that allows you to connect with others, with empathy and with respect. And so when we connect with our deepest, most inner human resourcefulness, that's when we become the person that we really want to be. That's when we feel alive. We all know that saying, know thyself, right? But the difference is, in know thyself, is in being thyself. That's when you feel alive. That's when you feel open. That's when you feel free. That's when you feel euphoric. When you I not just know myself, but as in also being myself. And so how I'd like to finish with you today is that if you think about it, the Australian story teaches us a couple of things. And the first thing is that if you need to fill up your clear targets by burning your boats and then by developing meaning, an intense meaning in your quest. And once you develop